morning, everyone. It's great to be here today with all of you. You may have already heard statements like AI is a game-changing technology, it's going to change the global economy, it's going to change humanity forever. But before it changes any of that, one thing it is absolutely already making an impact on is US power system. And data centers, which are the key ingredients of actually building AI models, are at the heart of this question. Data centers have been around for a long period of time. They've been built for decades. We've used them in cloud computing to answer your and my social media queries. We have used them in telecom to have voice and data connectivity. Crypto mining companies have used them to produce bitcoins and cryptocurrency. Large enterprise and corporations around the world use it for use cases like customer support applications. We use them in edge computing. For example, when you are in an autonomous car and real-time decisions are being taken on whether to take a left turn or not, right? That's where a data center comes in as well. And they're used in other applications like weather forecasting. But they are the talk of the town today because they are needed to actually train large language models and then use them for AI inference as well when you and I ask a question of a model like ChatGPT. So data centers are starting to come up everywhere. If you look inside a data center, the most critical component is a specialized chip that does the computation. And multiple chips are combined together to form servers. And all these servers are linked together inside a data center to create pods. And when you combine the capacity of all the pods together, it gives you the computational ability of the data center, also called the IT capacity of the data center. It consumes, the IT capacity consumes roughly 70% of all the electricity of an average data center today. And another 20% of the electricity in the data center is consumed because of cooling technology, because you have to maintain a certain level of temperature on the chips and the servers. The companies that are building these data centers are largely split into two different categories. The first one are specialized builders, owners, and operators of data centers. These firms actually rent out server capacity to their clients. But more importantly, large tech giants, also now known in the market as hyperscalers, are the big builders of data centers of the future. And the reason for that is obviously they want to build their own AI models and they want you and me to use their AI models in the future. Thankfully, the AI-based data centers tend to be more energy efficient than their traditional peers. The efficiency of a data center is defined by a factor called power usage efficiency or effectiveness. It's essentially a factor or a ratio where you divide the IT capacity of the data center, which is used for computation, divided by the overall power consumption of the data center, which includes ancillary load like cooling. And a theoretical power usage efficiency of 1 is an ideal, but almost impossible to achieve. But a trend that we are seeing is that efficiency of data centers increasing, PUE is declining from roughly 1.4 as an average for data centers in the US today to a forecasted almost 1.1 by 2035. So data centers are getting more efficient. But as data centers get more efficient, and as the cost of doing a computation declines, the tech companies are actually building bigger and bigger and bigger data centers using a larger amount of chips, using a larger amount of power capacity, because they want to solve more complex calculations, right? And therefore, data centers are becoming bigger and bigger. In 2024, of all the data centers commissioned in the US or operational in the US, the total average power capacity was 50 megawatts. But the new data centers that are expected to be built are 10x to 20x bigger. And these require, therefore, a lot more electricity. So you are going to see a scenario in the future, in the near future, in the next decade or so, where power demand growth because of data centers is a bigger factor in electricity system in the US compared to technologies like electric vehicles, which we were just talking about, or even industrial electrification, including producing new fuels like green hydrogen. So data centers are really like the big driver of power demand in the US power system in the next decade. However, one challenge that the industry faces, it takes a while to build up a data center today. It takes roughly 4.5, 5 years to imagine about building a data center, to getting the land, then getting all the regulatory permissions, then actually having your utility accept an interconnection request on the power system. And then once you've done all of that, it still takes you 2-2.5 years to actually construct and commission the data center. If you are in an AI arms race, this is really a big problem for you, because you want the data center yesterday, and you would have wanted to release your LLM model today, right? So you don't want to wait for a long period of time. And therefore, companies that are building data centers are trying to get ahead of the problem by creating a huge pipeline of data centers across the US. But when they try and decide where exactly to build the data center, there are a few factors to consider. The first is you can't really build a data center in a place which does not really have new incremental electricity generation capacity, right? So availability of power is a very critical issue. And if you look at where power generation capacity or power plants are being built across the US, there are a few states that stand out. California is one of them. Texas is absolutely the other one. There are parts of the Midwest where you see new power generation capacity being built. And there are states in the East Coast where new power capacity is also coming up. So this is a critical factor to look at. But the next one is cost of electricity. So it's good to have the electricity, but if it's really expensive, that's another problem, right? On average, an industrial load in the US pays almost $80 a megawatt hour for its electricity. States like California tend to be much more expensive. States like Texas tend to be much more cheaper. And then parts of the Midwest and East are kind of somewhere in the between, right? So cost of electricity is a factor. And if you are a large tech company building these data centers, you obviously have to deal with public opinion, you have to deal with regulatory requirements, you have to deal with investor requirements as well. And therefore, you want to site these data centers in places where you can find clean power as well, or green electricity. One problem, though, right now is that the states that produce the most green electricity in the US are not the ones where new power generation capacity is coming up, right? So it's becoming a difficult proposition to have all of these things together. Beyond electricity, data center operators also need to take into account a few other factors. One of the most important one is actually availability of internet exchange points, IXPs. These are places where you can have good connectivity to local audiences, to regional audiences, to national audiences, and probably to international audiences as well, right? Some of the largest IXPs in the US exist in cities like Washington, DC, in Atlanta, in Chicago, in Dallas as well. And therefore, these places and these cities are becoming important hubs of where new data centers can be built. And last but not least, tax incentives are really important. The new data centers that are being built for AI model training and inference tend to run in hundreds of millions of dollars, if not billions of dollars, for each data center. And because there's a huge drag on your balance sheet to build, any amount of tax incentive or tax breaks will go a long way in helping you take an investment decision. 75% of all the data centers that exist in the US today are actually in states which already have a tax incentive to build a data center. Anyways, I've talked about five different factors. You would probably want to combine all of them together to see where the most optimum locations are. When you do so, a few hotspots emerge. Virginia is called the data center alley of the world. It has the highest concentration of data centers for any place on Earth, and it will continue to be called the data center alley of the world for the foreseeable future. But there are new areas emerging, particularly in the Midwest, and also states like Ohio, but more importantly, large states like Texas as well, where new power capacity is being built, and you have enough gas infrastructure in those states as well. So this is where new data centers are coming up. But if you kind of plot out where these new data centers are in terms of whether the power that will be used to feed these data centers is cheap or clean, overwhelmingly, you are starting to see a trend where new data centers are coming up in locations where power is cheaper, and it may not be as clean as you would want it to be. So that's a push and pull factor that developers have to actually start balancing in the future. Another outcome of the situation is the fact that traditionally data centers used to be in urban areas, but increasingly, slowly and steadily though, data centers are starting to become bigger, and they're starting to get sited in suburban areas and slightly more remote locations. So a huge question I'd leave you with today is, are communities in suburban regions, in remote regions of this country, well-placed to take the heat of these data centers when they require huge amount of power demand, they require significant amount of water as well, and they require significant amount of land. It's a $1 billion question, if not a $1 trillion question. Thank you so much.